Well, howdy ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to X4 with the Star Wars mod. We are doing the Cradle of Humanity DLC. But yeah, even though I just started a new start, I'm going to be including another new start. So I got a little bit of bad news because the compatibility patch is coming. You don't actually have to, but you're going to be missing out on a lot of new features. But you'll have to start a new campaign. It's kind of sad that, like, starting a new campaign again for all of the things. Yeah, Shulo put out two messages yesterday. One in the Patreon exclusive and one in the announcements. I'm going to share both of these with you. They should be up on screen right now. So he's talking about here that we're going to have to be doing a new start. That it's not mandatory, it's not required. But there's a lot of implementations that he's bringing to the game that a new start would be able to benefit from. So yeah, that's the problem. That's the sad part. We will be doing another new start, but I'll try to go through as quickly as I can, and so that way you guys don't have to see the beginning stage stuff that you guys have already seen. But it will be a new start. So we'll have defined sectors all over again and stuff like that. And I'll probably be doing that on Sunday for the live stream, because the patch should be out by either Friday or Saturday. So that's the good news. But we're going to go ahead and hop in here. As you can see, I'm up to 2.9 million now. So that's the good news. We're also allied with the Corporate Sector Authority. I've been running missions just nonstop, picking up patrols, picking up people and delivering them to stations and destroying mines and everything like that. So we got another extra hour in just mission grinding. And where we left off where we left off last time was, sitting here thinking, but yeah, where we left off earlier this week, we are actually doing some really cool stuff. We were left off at like 13 rep with CSA, also trying to do as many missions as we could and just selling stuff. But anyways, I'm just going to fast forward here through the loading screen. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen, at our Scar H6. So yeah, we're going to be selling this thing as soon as possible. We now have access to this. So once I hit level 20, I immediately came straight here, just so that way we could grab this thing. Alright, so I already have a new preset set up for it and everything like that. It's going to cost us 1.2 million. Really? When I logged off, it was 900k. Now it's 1.2. Okay, fine. Alright, so the other thing that we're going to be buying as well is an M-class ship. We're going to be buying the CSS-1 Corellian Star. Now, these things are really nice because of their storage capacity is 12,400 compared to our Gazantes that we were using last series with 9,500. So we're going to be able to get more out of it. We're going to get a minimum preset, another 1.2 million, but we are going to be adding shields to it. So let's go ahead and throw these shields on. Let's throw on the blaster, and we're going to throw on an RH3 as well. So that's 1.5, and we're not going to go with a bunch of crew. We are, however, going to be grabbing a trading computer extension. Now, let's go ahead and tackle enemies and defend. Alright, we're just going to put them on both and defend. Alright, so that's going to cost us 1.4, so I'm just going to go ahead and add a shopping list here. Now, I haven't actually checked out, not that I've really tried it anyways, to see what actually is trading for the best right now. I'd really like to see what's really looking good for buy-sell. And as you guys can see, they have nerfed a lot of the prices here. So, yeah, I'm not liking what they did, but there is news on updating the trades, at least when I was talking to Mick. That they're going to be trying to focus more on like the factions trading and stuff like that. And so we should see another price increase on a lot of these things. But it looks to me like microchips is going to be our best bet for right now, because selling for $795 and buying for $1,090. So we're going to go ahead and try to do that. So let's see, filter settings. And we're going to turn that off. Okay. All right. So let's go ahead and once these things get built, we're going to go ahead and tell them to do their trades. Now, let's go ahead and sell ship here. Get our money back. All right. So now we're sitting back at 842,000. I'm looking forward to this R41 Star Chaser, and that's really what I want to cover today, is the R41. Another thing, too, that we're probably going to be doing is trying to build a station. So we're probably going to dock over here and see what the Corporate Sector Corporate Security Division, sorry, always want to say the Corporate Sector, but see what they've got for sale. If not, then we're going to go over to where we've already got our big relations with and see what modules they have that we can start trading with. Probably going to set up like a solar panel station to start with, but I'd really like to get to doing some sort of like medical supply / like food rations place. Anyways, so I'm just going to fast forward here to where we've got our ships. And my word, that Crusader looks so good. I think that's a Death Watch. I'm going to swear on it. And then, so I'll talk to you guys here in a second. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen, with our R41. I'm sorry for the lag. There's just a lot of ships coming in and out, in and out, in and out. And a few people have already been talking about, like, the poor optimizations with Cradle of Humanity coming. And, like, there's been performance drops and such. So that's definitely one interesting way to get in and out of the ship here. Invisible ladder. Alright, so let's go ahead and tell this guy to hop out. We're going to hop in here. I like the dashboard. Dashboard looks good. So let's go ahead and take this thing for a test drive. Ooh, like the blasters on it. Roll rate and turn rate feels good. Now, I know I've talked about this ship a lot with, like, performance and everything like that. For dollar for performance, that this thing's going to be a really nice addition to anybody's fleet. The speed feels good. It's not as nimble as, like, a TIE Interceptor, from what I'm feeling. But she is nimble enough. And that's what we want. Just nimble enough. But for the price tag, like, she's really, really good. And like I was saying, it's like, I don't know why it cost me $1.2 million. I think it's because they're building a lot of ships as well. And that is a pillager. Black Sun. Alright, so let's test this thing out. As long as we sit right here between the engines, they shouldn't be able to shoot us back. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and boost away. Wait for our weapons to cool off. And those are concussion missiles, guys. This thing only comes armed with concussion missiles, so I really like this thing. This thing is going to be great for cleaning up lots of enemy fighters. So he's got spacefly eggs. We don't want those. No, we're not going to grab any of those. Alright. But yeah, that was actually pretty good. I figured we were going to take a lot more damage than that. Another thing too, like the UI that's going on, like, the only fix that I found is by putting it for full screen and then switching it back, and I apologize. I don't have that set. Anyways, so this is our first look at the R41. So, let's go ahead and order our new trader here. Start doing some manual trades with microchips. So, we want him to buy. We need to get him leveled up. And we're going to sell. And there we go. So we're just gonna click on whole parts here, just that way. No, no, not whole parts. Sorry, microchips. There we go. So we're just gonna keep doing this over and over and over again, guys. And so this is a good way, if you especially been running learning all the things, modeling in the description with the collection, which I still need to update, and I apologize about that, guys. But yeah, with learning all the things, they should be leveling up quite well. They'll level up a lot faster than how the vanilla EgoSoft has it set. But yeah, it's like you just do these manual trades just like this over and over again, get a nice assortment of orders placed, and they level up over time. And we're gonna add whole parts on here because I think whole parts is gonna be pretty good too. Yeah, there we go. 81,000 profit. Nice. We'll wait on the microchips to start resupplying here. Let's do another microchips. I don't think we're going to get that much off of it. Yeah, we're not going to get that much. They're pretty much tapped out. Still 77,000 increase, though. So right there, 1.4 million due from trades. So that's pretty good. And with that, we'll go on ahead and buy another one of these guys and set them up as well. But yeah, so while that's going on, what's our money at right now? 395,000. Okay. So I think buying a plot is going to cost us, let's see, if we were to create a plot. Ooh, 74,000. That's not bad. Let's see if what happens if we add 2 kilometers in every single direction. Because two by two is just not enough. Okay, so 594,000. We almost have enough. So let's see what we got for mission offers if I fly out this way. So 594,000 isn't that bad. And we can definitely create an energy cell station quite easily with that. Alright, so we got some mission offers. Let's see what they are. Xenon military studies, destroying mines. And as you guys can see, it's like the price has really increased a lot for those. Destroying more mines. And pick up. And see, these right here, the ship left me behind. Like, these used to cost, like... Oh, that's not going to work. Because I'm pretty sure the Defender Light Corvette doesn't actually have a dock. So that's going to be a bug mission. But what I was saying, though, is... actually, no, it does have a dock. Yeah, let's go ahead and accept that, too. We'll do this one first. But yeah, it's like I've just been stacking missions. And these used to be like 40,000 a pop for these missions. So missions have definitely improved a heck of a lot. So just bear that in mind, too, guys, that missions are quite profitable now. They're not that much of a waste of time. And the rep is also increased by a lot, too. It's like, I wouldn't be surprised we're like plus 22 after just doing these 3 missions. So, let's bear that in mind as well. But yeah, let's go ahead and just do these missions very quick. Alright, so here's that Defender. Is that it? Docking granted. Yeah, that's the Defender. Alright, so we're just going ahead and try to dock here. And I think it's on the off to the side, if I remember correctly. Yeah. And there we go. We just have to dock. Alright, and there we are. All docked and ready to go. So now, we're just going to undock again. Alright, so now we're just going to go kill some mines. Friend, foe, mine. Friend, foe, mine. Friend, foe, mine. Alright, so hopefully you guys saw the end of those mines, and right there, look, reputation plus 2 gain with corporate sector division just for clearing out mines. So, like I said, rep has been increased, and the amount of money that you make off these missions have also been increased. So, after doing those 3 missions, we're back at 915,000. So, like, it doesn't take long at all for these missions. So, anyways, let's go back to managing our plot here. And we want 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, and 4. And then we're going to create a new plot. And 594,000, just like we were talking about earlier. Buy the license, continue. Now, so we have the soya beans already, but we're just going to go with energy cells for right now. So let's go ahead and get our basic dock. And then our 3 dock. And then we're going to go with our storage modules. Storage container. Right there. And yeah, we're going to need another module here. Let's get the cross. I haven't really messed with Tawadi stuff before. So this is a whole new... Parented. Parented modules before. I've never really messed with them. So this is a whole new experience for me. So we're going to go ahead and grab this. And then we're going to go ahead and slot that there. Slot that there, and we're going to get another cross. Oop. Nope, I need you elsewhere. Come on, come on. There we go. And another cross. Okay, so now we're going to give our storage modules again, container and container, and then we're going to add on our production modules for the energy cells. So with these energy cells, we're going to put that there. I don't think we have enough room for another slot there. So we're just going to go ahead and just throw on these 2. And then we're going to try and actually move this whole thing as over as far as possible. Okay. It's as far as we can go with it. And then what we're going to do is we're going to add on some more slots on the end here. Because we just want to produce as much solar cells as possible. So we're going to add on another cross there. And let's go ahead and throw on the storage module again. And then production. And then we're just going to copy module and put it there. Alright, so there is our solar array. I'm probably going to add some more docks as well. Just so that way we can facilitate more traders and such. Yeah, that should be good. I don't think we got enough storage capacity, but that should be good to start. Because the only thing that we're really going to be doing is finding a builder is going to be difficult. Now that I'm sitting here looking at it. I remember us putting some satellites somewhere. Where do we put them? And we're going to have to find a builder. Until then. But alright guys. So there is our trade station. It's going to cost $7.5 million. So we're just going to throw in like $50,000. For now. Alright, so like I said, this is going to be a quick, short video, especially since we're going to have to be restarting all this all over again anyways. But yeah, I hope you guys have enjoyed. If you guys haven't already, go ahead and like and subscribe down below. And we're going to be doing a lot more X4 goodness for the weeks to come, the next few days. So I will catch you guys in the next one. Laters, everybody.